Hi, and welcome to this tutorial on the MakeUp tool in MPFB. My name is Joel Palmius, and I am the Community Manager of the MakeHuman community. In this video, I will cover the basics of drawing ink layers for implementing MakeUp. While not strictly speaking necessary, you will most likely benefit from having watched the series on the MPFB materials before continuing, but it should be possible to understand the contents here anyway. The MakeUp tool in MPFB is used as a non-destructive way to add color on top of a skin texture. Traditionally, you would paint directly on top of a copy of an image texture. But this is cumbersome, error-prone, and hard to reuse for other characters. With the MakeUp tool, you can create reusable makeup which can be used independently of which underlying skin texture you want. It will not matter if the underlying skin texture is Caucasian, African, or Asian. The ink layers should be possible to add on top of it anyway. Anyway, as a basic outline, this video will first show you how to access the MakeUp tool and what to do to get started. Then the core concepts of focus and ink layer will be explained. A more hands-on section will demonstrate how to actually paint the MakeUp. This will have a technical focus, explaining the functionality. Details of the various visual aspects of MakeUp will be discussed in later videos. Finally, we will get into loading and saving MakeUp, as well as mentioning what the limitations for that are. But let's start with the tool as such. In the viewport, I have a normal character with a Make skin material. I have just added a mask modifier to hide the rest of the body, as those parts are irrelevant for the tutorial. To find the MakeUp tool, you can navigate to the Create Assets and MakeUp panel. This panel might look basic and somewhat anonymous, but the real magic happens in the Texture Paint panel. Anyway, what you do here is create a layer you can paint on. We will get into what a focus is in a bit, but the safe choice here is Face Focus. We will also go with the default for the resolution. A 4K by 4K image texture is probably a bit overkill here, but basically you can choose what best fits the level of detail you intend to paint. Then we click the Create button. Nothing changes visibly, which is expected. But what you have done here is add a completely transparent layer on top of the skin. Before moving to the Texture Paint tab, we will just make sure all vertices are selected in Edit mode. We'll get back to why after having discussed what a focus is. Now we move to the Texture Paint tab. Here we first make sure that we are in Material Preview mode. While it is possible to paint in other viewport modes, you will likely run into the least amount of confusion with the Material Preview mode. Then we make sure we have the new ink layer selected. Now we can start to paint. I'll just draw basic geometric figures here for demonstration purposes. Oops, I made a mistake, obviously completely without intending to. However, since we're not painting directly on the skin, this is easy to fix even without undoing. We'll simply switch to Erase Alpha mode and remove the parts we are unsatisfied with. So what did we do here? Each layer we paint on consists of two parts. The first is a focus, which we will get into shortly. The other is an image texture using the focus as a layout. Together, these two form an ink layer, which can be saved and reloaded on different characters. When stacking ink layers on top of each other, they will use the alpha channel for mixing so that a hole in an upper layer will reveal the corresponding part of a lower layer. Taking a quick look in the Shader Nodes tab, we can see that a few extra nodes have been added to the Make skin material. If you take a look at the topmost texture node, you can see that it has the alpha socket connected to the specific ink layer mixer node. Also, especially note that there are UV nodes in the left part of the setup. Here you can see the ink layer image and the body skin texture uses different UV maps. Which leads us to the concept of focus. If you do not already know what a UV map is, it is possible that you might want to pause the video here and Google for it. But in summary, it is a way to distribute the faces of a mesh over a 2D plane. When texture painting, this maps the parts of the image to the corresponding face. Such distribution of faces is called UV unwrapping. When UV unwrapping, you specify where the seams are in the mesh. That is, where should the mesh be cut in order to distribute the faces efficiently? In order to allow more detail in textures, the MakeUp tool comes with a series of such UV unwraps. In the image here, you can see an unwrap where the seams have been placed around the face. The face faces have then been expanded to cover most of the plane. All other unrelated faces of the body have been scaled down and put in a corner of the image. Thus, if you put a pink dot in that corner, most of the body would go pink. Such an UV unwrap is called a focus in MakeUp, because essentially it focuses on a specific part of the body. Let's compare the effect this has. I will set up two ink layers on the body. One, the full body focus, is exactly the same UV map as is used for the main skin texture. The other, a focus centering on the eyelids. We'll use a low resolution texture, as that will be easier to discuss later. In the texture paint editor, we first select the full body ink layer. To the left, you can see an outline of the UV layout. What you see here are the selected vertices, which is why I previously said it is important to select all vertices. Let's change this now to only select the vertices around the eyes. Back in texture paint mode, I'll draw a ring around the left eye. Now I'll quickly switch back to the layout tab and select the other UV map. Now we will draw a ring around the other eye, but on the eyelid focus ink layer. Comparing the two ink layers side by side, we can see the difference the focus makes when it comes to detailed real estate. In a 1K by 1K image, we get 50 pixels worth of detail for the eyelid when using the full body focus. However, when we use the eyelid focus, we get 220 pixels to play with, this on the same texture resolution. The MakeUp tool comes with an assortment of focuses. Depending on what you want to achieve, you would pick the one that provides the best resolution for the body part you want to paint. The focuses you see here are the main categories. On top of this, you have subcategories. Many of these come in different variants, which will be called solid or split. In a solid variant, there are no cuts internally in the area which is focused on. The benefit is that you get no seams to take into account. In a split variant, there are cuts internally. The benefit is that the faces then better match their actual relative size when unwrapped. If all this sounds confusing and overwhelming, then just go with the solid face focus. It will be the basic one-size-fits-all approach, which is the easiest to understand and paint. Now, with this knowledge, we are ready to actually paint MakeUp. The goal here is to have two ink layers. One will contain a purple eyeshadow, the other will contain a basic black eyeliner. I will pick the eye narrow solid focus for both and be satisfied with a 2K by 2K resolution. Since we don't want the eyeshadow to cover the eyeliner, we will paint the eyeshadow on the lower layer. However, to get better access, I'll lower the eyelids before texture painting. The character has a rigify rig here, and the eyelids are on the usually hidden primary face layer. Now we can start painting. First, we make sure we're on the lower ink layer. Then we enable X symmetry. Now let's paint the eyeshadow. Okay, so I am no great makeup artist, but this will have to suffice for the demo. Now we raise the eyelids again. Next, we switch to the upper ink layer. Again, a bit basic, but I'm sure you get the idea. Now we will save the ink layers to the library. Let's load a different character in the viewport. I'll use the multi-layered skin material here, just to demonstrate that you are not limited to make skin. Now we can find our saved ink layers in the library. If the ink layers are not visible, try restarting Blender in between to rescan the asset directory. We load them in the order they should stack. As for limitations, the MakeUp will work with either make skin or multi-layered. However, when you create MakeUp, you need to do so on top of MakeSkin. MakeUp does not support Game Engine or Enhanced Skins. If you need such skins, you would need to bake the MakeUp into a new diffuse texture. But that is a different topic for another day. Anyway, that concludes the tutorial. Thank you for watching and happy modeling.